Hi there. We are researchers at Western University, interested in finding out how the brain works and in how children's brains change as they grow and learn new things. Why are there so many differences between children? One way that we study this is through brain imaging. We look at what happens in the brains of children while doing different learning activities. It's perfectly safe, and you get to see a picture of your brain afterwards. While a normal camera uses light to take pictures, our special camera, called a magnetic resonance imaging scanner, uses magnets to take pictures. It's important that we follow two special rules. One, we cannot bring metal objects into the scanner, like keys, phones, jewelry, or braces. And two, we have to keep very still inside the scanner. Just as normal pictures are blurry when you move around, pictures of your brain will become very blurry if you move inside the scanner. You should know that the scanner sometimes makes loud noises, but this is totally normal. If you don't want to continue, you can tell the researcher to stop the scan at any time. Today, Sam is participating in our research. Sam comes to the university, plays some games, and does some tasks. Also, Sam will get to go to the pretend scanner. This pretend scanner looks like the real scanner, but it cannot take pictures of Sam's brain. Researchers just use it to practice and to give kids a chance to see what it would be like to go into a real scanner. Sam even practices some computer activities inside the pretend scanner. If Sam was okay with the pretend scanner, Sam returns to meet the researchers at the real scanner. First, the researchers make sure that Sam does not bring any metal objects into the scanner. Then, earplugs are put in Sam's ears for protection from the loud noises that the scanner makes. Finally, Sam lies down and a kind of helmet is put over Sam's face. Do not worry, Sam is still able to see. Once Sam is comfortable on the scanner bed, it's time to go into the scanner and have brain pictures taken. The scanner bed slowly goes up and then into the scanner. Sam does some computer activities and watches a movie, but it is important that Sam tries to keep very still. The researchers talk to Sam through the intercom, before and in between the activities. When the scan is finished, the researchers and Sam can see the pictures of Sam's brain, and Sam can take a picture home to show friends. If other children participate in our research, like Sam did, we can better understand what happens in the brains of children and why there are differences between people.